Today I will speak about something that many people inside the metalheads, inside the metal community, they make videos about it, and they speak about their 10 awful albums of their collection, except of Set Anger of Metallica. So it was a little bit difficult to collect only 10 albums, unfortunately. So here I will speak about something a little bit 20 or 21 albums that for me they are the worst of the worst of my CD collection, of my metal collection. But I have also to say that it is my personal opinion, of course. And many people, maybe they have different ideas and different opinions, and it's okay. So, first of all, I have to speak about one of the most, let's say, worst albums of all time. And this is the fifth album of Danzig. Yes, I know. I like so much the four first albums of him, and also let's say that I like also the 6th and the 7th album, the 8th and 9th album very much of Danzig. But here, in the 5th album, he tried to make a connection with the industrial, but with not a really good way. So this is the 5th album of Danzig, Black Iced Evil, let's say this is the name of the album. It's a very bad connection between metal of Danzig and industrial metal. It's something like that. Now, I will continue one album that some people, maybe they prefer it, they like it, but I think this is the worst album of Black Sabbath. And I'm speaking about this album, Forbidden. This was also the last album with Martin in the vocals. Unfortunately, because I like very much Martin and the era of Martin. But this album, Forbidden, is so not Black Sabbath. It's a little even more modern, with some body count influences in their music. And here there are some good songs. For example, I Won't Cry For You is a very, very good ballad, but and Kiss of Death is also very good, but most of the album is not Black Sabbath. Together with Set Anger, I will also put in the same place. Maybe it's a little bit more good than Set Anger. Risk of Megadeth. Of course, this album came out in the same years with Set Anger, and it was the story is going like that. Ulrich said to Dave that he does not make risks about his music, so he wanted to make a risk, so he called the album also Risk. Here also we can find some very good songs. For example, the song Time, the Beginning and Time the End is a very, very good song that closed the album. But the other songs is not exactly Megadeth. And I'm continue with one of the worst albums of my favorite one of my favorite bands, Manowar, and their album. This is the album. Sons of War. Okay. This is the album. Okay, let's say that this album was so awful. For what reason? Here and there were some good songs inside the album, but most of the songs, they are not exactly they're even more, let's say, symphonic. Reminds me a not so good style of Rhapsody of Fire. in most of this album, unfortunately. And for this reason, I think this is a bad album of Manowar. Another also good album of Bathory, of Gorthon, and I'm speak about Octagon. Some people also will put here Requiem, but let's say Requiem is a little bit better than Octagon. Requiem is a little bit more punkies, but here in Octagon, I don't know what Gorthon he wanted to do with this album. I continue with Anthrax. Anthrax in the 90s, they were very, very low, and this is for me the ground zero point of them. Stomp 442. This is a not good album. Yes, here they have some Pantera influences. Also, their friends of Pantera, they played some together with them some songs, but also this is not the Anthrax that we like. Now another even more close to our period album that I didn't like at all, Dream Theater and their album The Astonishing. This is a very boring album from a double album with 34 songs. Yes, this is not all. The problem is not the length. Let's say the most problem here of this album is that it's so boring, unfortunately. Another album that I didn't like at all, Enforcer. And their last album until now, Zenith. This is not their Zenith, this is their Nadir. Nadir point, not their Zenith point. Came out in 2019. For me, this was the worst album of 2019. Unfortunately, this is not the force that we know. Another not so good album, Stratovarius. They came back with Timo Toki for this album, the so-called also Stratovarius album, and this album was not good. Also, here you can find some good songs from here and there, but most of the album is not there. Here also they have a song by the name Zenith of Power. No, this is not Zenith, also. Another very boring album of one of my favorite bands, Blind Guardian, and this album by the name Beyond the Red Mirror, so boring. Unfortunately, this is a not good album of Blind Guardian. And another also German power metal band that I like so much, Running Wild, the first pirate metal band. And they made a very bad album. This is the album, Shadow Maker. They made it in 2012. This is not pirate metal at all. I don't know also what Ralph he was thinking when he made this album. This is even more hard rock than metal, let's say. But for me, this is an awful album, unfortunately. And then continue with Germany, another power metal band, Grave Digger. I like them so much. But for me, this is their worst album of them. And one of my worst albums, Liberty or Death. Here they have also, unfortunately, a song, Machada, about the Jewish history of the revolt of the Jewish of the last place of the Great Revolt, the Jewish Great Revolt against Rome. Masada in the Judea desert, but the song also is not so good. I prefer, for example, Masada will not fall of the Israeli band Desert. But all the album, I don't like it. Unfortunately, I don't like it. Another bad album of another also favorite US power metal band, Jack Panzer. And here is the album, their second album, if I'm not sure, by the name Dissident Alliance. They tried to be Pantera in the place of Pantera. They were one of the most famous US power metal bands. And to play Pantera style groove metal, no, this is not exactly a good album. And now Iron Maiden also. I like so much Iron Maiden, but unfortunately Virtual 11 is a bad album. Maybe here I would say that The Classman is a very good song. A little bit also I like Future Real, but the other songs, no. Also The Final Frontier, for instance, is a not good album of Iron Maiden, but this is the nadir point of them. And then continue with England, with another very famous heavy metal band, Judas Priest. And I many people prefer to put here Demolition, but when Demolition came out, I like it. What I didn't like, I don't like, of the whole discography of Judas Priest, this is this album by the name Nostradamus. Yes, the song Nostradamus is great, but the whole album is also very boring. Now, one of my favorite US death metal bands, Massacre. Also, they will make a new album in 2021. From Beyond, this is one of my most favorite albums of all time. But they made this awful album by the name Promise. Yes, Promise. Promise, and in this album they tried to play something like gothic metal, something like that. And this is not Massacre that we know with them, unfortunately. And also their gothic metal is not good. Now Sepultura from Brazil, and after Roots, when Max Cavalera left the band, and they made this album by the name Against, that I didn't like it at all. The only song that I like here is one song that New Institute of Metallica, of ex-Metallica, played with them. Except of the song Hatred Aside that New Institute played with them, the album is not... Is not a good album, unfortunately. Now another bad album of another favorite, one of my favorite thrash metal bands from United States, Helloween Eve. They played style of speed thrash metal, but they made a reunion in the beginning of the millennium, and they made this album. That this is not a good album. The album is Evil Never Dies, okay, but the album is not good at all, unfortunately. And if I'm speaking about Helloween Eve, this is the album of Nuclear Assault by the name Third World Genocide. Also, I like so much Nuclear Assault, but this album is an awful album of them, unfortunately. Here I could also speak about Exodus and their album Force of Habit. Okay, this is not exactly the Exodus that we like it then. And another most even more modern album, Machine Head, and their last full studio album until now of them, Catharsis. Also, this is a not good album in my point of view of Machine Head. Another two albums that I will speak here, Paradise Lost and their awful album, Believe in Nothing, also a not good album at all. Also Paradise Lost, today they speak against this album. And another also album, In Flames, and their album, Siren Charms, also I don't understand what was in their mind when they made this album. Many people also will speak about other albums like Cold Lake of Celtic Frost, for example, or like Chameleon of Halloween, but for me these are the most awful worst albums that I have in my collection. From Israel, from Jerusalem, Stay Metal and Stay Heavy.